All right, so we're actually going to play first. I think a lot of the time in Sealed, you will draw first. But one of the benefits of going 18 lands in our deck is that we actually are pretty aggressive. So this allows us to kind of get some early damage in and then finish with our fatties and our Grey Merchants, which is the key right there, Grey Merchant. So we get to do things like maybe get a hit in with Arena Athlete before we can do anything. Again, this is one of those awkward hands where we have Anger of the Gods. But we'll figure it out. Bestow reads. Yeah. All right, so lead with this guy. I can always put this on him, get his heroic ability, which is fine. It's not the greatest ability, but I can trigger that, and then when I use Anger of the Gods, I'll end up with a Death Toucher in play, which is kind of nice. It's the same as if I held this, theoretically, but... Sure. I'm definitely just attacking here. If he wants to trade his Death Toucher for my 2-drop, I'm definitely okay with that. And the thing is, I don't know if he's willing to. Like, he very easily could just decide, nope, that's not a trade I want to do. And I just get in 2 damage. That's why the attack's worth it there. I think if I know 100% of the time he's going to block, I might not attack. But if there's any doubt whatsoever, I think it's pretty close enough. It's close enough that it's worth the attack. So this is pretty nice. I get to throw this onto here, making him gigantic. Oh, that's kind of an awkward combo. This exiles it, but whatever. But this guy will be a 4/5. So I can get in a hit. Next time I can even throw another thing on him if I really want. But it allows me to Anger the Gods without killing my Minotaur. Like I said, it does suck that this exiles creatures, so it doesn't really work with Night Howler in the same way that I would like it to, but it's going to get a 2-for-1 here, which I'm... It's going to get a 2-for-1 here, which I am totally okay with. I could even slow roll a little bit more if I wanted to, realistically. Well, now I kind of want to play it and play that guy. If he chumps blocks, obviously I'm no longer on the... Kill your things. So, next turn I can suit this guy up, drain him, and attack with a fairly large creature. 3/2. With that touch, that's the important thing. Interesting. Well, if he discards a creature, gets +2/+2, but my guy gets +1/+1, so he has to discard 2 creatures, which I'm okay with him doing. He might not have factored that into his plan. Because he discards 2 creatures and all he does is kill this. Yeah, I wonder if he realized he has to discard 2. Nope, he did not. Saw that one coming from about 30 miles away. He is right now in disbelief. I've been playing with Night Howler for quite a while, so I know how the card works, but a lot of people do not play against it. I could have played my land there, but I don't really see a reason to. Excuse me. I have a bit of a sore throat, so I'm drinking some hot liquid, but I will try to keep away from the mic. Alright, so we're obviously just attacking a few blocks, just pumping up my guy, and he's taking a million. Down to two. That's a pretty low, my friend. Well, he probably has the fight card, and he's going to kill these. He's still going to be pretty far behind. Nope. Packs it in. So he is... What was the second color? He was green, and he was... Did I see any other things that were... I think he was green-red, but I can't remember if he was green-black or green-red. Trying to think... Oh, he was green-black. He played the Death Touch guy. So I should definitely bring that in. And I'm on the draw, probably, so I'll just take out a land. Sure, take out a swamp.